Hi, I'm Jason Stahl, and I'm here with Joe Keane, automotive video producer at Babcox Media and ASC certified technician who has substantial experience with vehicle electronic systems. We're going to talk about post-repair scans next in the AirPro Diagnostics Garage. In our last video, we discussed a checklist of tasks repairers should perform after reassembly to make sure a vehicle's electronics are functioning properly. Today, we're going to be discussing the post-repair scan. Joe, why is a post-repair scan so critical?
Well, Jason, a post-repair scan is used to document all systems are functional and repaired correctly. Just clearing codes and not reading live module data can present a dangerous situation for the vehicle owner and the shop. Many shops look for the fix-all button, but professionals know it doesn't exist. A post-repair scan and checking live data values allows for documentation of proper repairs to electronics and safety systems. If any codes are still active, a shop must investigate why.
Well, what about calibrations?
Can't forget about these. At this point, you must perform any necessary calibration. Keep in mind, there are two types, static and dynamic. Static calibrations require fixed targets outside of the vehicle at specified distances, along with diagnostic software. This may involve anything from a post to aim at to a series of target boards required for cameras and lasers. Dynamic tests require moving the vehicle. In most dynamic calibrations, a proper diagnostic tool is used to trigger the main control module and place the vehicle into the dynamic calibration learn mode. While connected to the diagnostic tool through the OBD port, the vehicle must now be driven according to the OEM requirements until the computer has recognized all parameters and symbols.
That makes sense. Sometimes you can have both a static and dynamic calibration, right, Joe?
Yes. Combination static and dynamic calibrations are sometimes required based on vehicle manufacturer and model requirements. This would consist of the aiming of lasers and cameras and then driving so the cameras and lasers can acclimate to the vehicle.
Thanks, Joe. We've gone through all the steps to take when a damaged vehicle with ADAS comes into your shop. Through identifying ADAS systems, the pre-repair scan and blueprinting, the repair process, and finally, the post-repair scan and calibration. I'm Jason Stahl. Thanks for watching.